So here we have the Audi Q3 on a 14 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you around the outside of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside, you can see it's a 5-door car with alloy wheels. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of it from there. As we approach the back of the car, you'll see we have reversing sensors, plenty of boot space as well, along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat should you wish to increase this space even further. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of it, you can see it's in excellent condition the whole way round. Just briefly before we climb in, I think it's what we're seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that now. Okay, now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the left-hand side, we have the rev counter, and on the right-hand side, the speedometer and fuel gauge. In the middle, you can see the total miles for the car, which are 50,529. The information displayed above that can be changed using buttons on the steering wheel. There are various menus available for that section as well, so you can see there audio, your phone, navigation, and then back around to the beginning again. If we back out to the steering wheel, the buttons I was using a second ago are these ones over on the left-hand side. We also have stereo controls here as well. The phone controls that are up here can't be used until such time as you pair the phone up to the car, and that is done using the buttons in the center and the screen above it, which we'll come to in a moment. The buttons that I will use to operate the screen above are essentially this dial and that collection of four buttons. You can access some menus directly from here, as you can see, but I'll be using these buttons here for this demonstration I'm showing you now. So to pair your phone, you would highlight the telephone, you'd push the button down, and then you'd follow the instructions on screen from there. Satellite navigation is available in this car. You can see it's a nice clear color display. Again, I'm just using the dial and the buttons that surround it here. When it comes to radio, we've got a few different ways in which you can listen to the radio. DAB, FM and medium wave radio available for you. And then to listen to your own music, again, there's a few different ways of doing that. And they include Bluetooth audio. So once you pair your phone, you'll be able to make and receive phone calls, but you'll also be able to stream your music as well. Working our way down, we have the buttons I mentioned a moment ago, the main volume for the stereo. We have the CD player there as well. And then below that, that button turns off the stop and start. This car is designed to cut out when it's stationary in traffic to save you fuel. That system is now off. We can turn off the traction control. We can adjust the passenger temperature and the driver temperature independently of one another. We can determine where we'd like the air to be distributed once it enters the car. The air conditioning is on at the minute, so off, back on again. All hit auto. When you do that, the car will take control of the fan speed and the direction of the air to maintain the temperatures you've asked for. You can override that manually at any time you wish to. Your CO2 has now gone off. We then have a 6-speed manual gearbox, an electronic handbrake, a 12-volt charging socket, and a separate cigarette lighter or 12-volt charging socket there as well. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to give us a call here at Mach 1 Cars. We'd love to hear from you soon.